This is Dr. Scott Kilberg, the Video Foot Doc, here with another video for you on all things foot and ankle. Toenail surgery is very, very common, and most people who undergo it do so very successfully. Toenail surgery is performed for one of a couple different reasons. Part of the nail can be removed because of an ingrown toenail, and in the cases of really thick and misshapen or painful toenails, often the entire nail is removed. Now, in most cases, this is done permanently, in which a chemical is applied to the nail root cells to destroy the nail root cells so they never grow back again. And so the problem with the toenail doesn't continue to regenerate as it regrows. Well, an uncommon complication that can occur from this procedure is actual regrowth of the nail itself. Now, this sometimes occurs. Out of the hundreds of these procedures I perform a year, I get a few that do grow back either partially or wholly from time to time. The reason for this regrowth is fairly specific. The reason why it doesn't occur very frequently is because most of the time the procedures that are used to destroy the nail root cells are very successful, and most of the cells, if not all the cells that regenerate nail, are completely destroyed in the process. But occasionally, sometimes some of those cells can be missed. There's a couple different reasons why those cells would survive this process. A chemical typically is used to destroy the nail root cells, something called phenol, also known as carboxylic acid. Now, when this chemical is applied to the nail root cells during the process of the surgery on the toenail, it's applied directly to an area called the nail matrix, which is where the cells grow the nail outward. Now, in some cases, if one has too much bleeding that's going on during this procedure, say they have a big toe that has a very large vein network and there's a lot of oozing during this procedure, the blood or body fluid of the toe itself can actually neutralize this chemical before it has a chance to completely destroy the nail root cells, and some of those cells can survive to grow further nail another day. Another reason why the chemical wouldn't work as effectively is if the chemical has simply been around for too long. Now, in most podiatrists' office who perform this procedure every day, this is not a problem. But in like a primary care doctor's office or family doctor in which this procedure is not commonly performed, that chemical can sit on the shelf for a little while, and eventually over time it becomes less effective. And so when this less effective chemical is applied to the tissue, it does not destroy the nail cells as efficiently as it should, and some of those nail root cells do survive in order to grow nail further on down the road after the recovery process is over. Now, there is yet another reason why nail cells can continue to survive in order to grow more nail out after these procedures are performed. In performing these procedures, the person who is doing it needs to be careful that all the nail tissue is completely removed, as well as any of the attaching material that helps kind of bind the nail down at that level and keep it attached to the underside of the skin surface where it grows from. Sometimes some of this tissue can be left intact during the nail removal process. It can rip away a little bit, and some of that rubbery type tissue that's found at the base of the nail can stay in there. And when that chemical is applied to the nail root cells to try to destroy them, instead of encountering the nail root cells, the chemical basically encounters this rubbery fibrous-like tissue that serves as part of the attachment of the very beginning of the nail. And the chemical works on that, but doesn't actually get into contact with the nail root cells, and therefore some of the cells, if not a good deal of them, can survive the process and continue to regenerate nail after the procedure is healed. It's fairly easy to fix this issue. When nail cells regrow nail after one of these procedures, they'll either do so by forming kind of a little sliver if only part of them remain, or if the entirety of the nail cells regrow, then the entire nail will regrow back with it after several months. But the procedure can simply be repeated with greater care and keeping in mind some of the potential reasons for why the nail actually grew back in the first place. And generally on a second attempt, it's usually successful for getting rid of this nail permanently. One other thing to mention, though, is a lot of times when someone has nail removal, especially if it's the complete nail that's being removed and not just partial nail or a border of a nail, once the nail is completely removed, there's skin on the undersurface of where the nail used to sit. And that skin is like any other skin. It can form a nice hard surface if it's subjected to pressure. And this particular skin isn't necessarily used to dealing with overlying pressure from shoes and other things pushing down on it, such as a thick, heavy sock or whatnot. And when a little bit more pressure is applied to this skin, after time, that skin might actually start to callus up a little bit, and so a thin, flaky form of callus can develop over the top of this skin. And oftentimes people will mistake this callus layer actually for being new nail, when in fact it's not technically nail tissue, but it's simply hard, flaky callus that might look like a really thin nail is still attached to the skin over the toe. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please look for more videos on all things foot and ankle on this site as well as others, or you may check out my website at www.inpodiatrygroup.com. Thank you.